Hi guys, welcome to Alpha Male Official. I'm Arapata Makalio. This is Pania. Nick and Coey. Thank you guys for coming and thank you guys for watching. I have a couple of questions for you. Question one. If you could be the Prime Minister for one day, what would you change and why?
I wouldn't be the Prime Minister, I would be the ruler. Because Prime Ministers can only do certain things. Oh, and I would start again. The system ain't working.
Awesome.
It's not. Okay. Yeah, go after that.
That's an awesome question. I would do something radical where I will become the Prime Minister for more than one day. So, and I don't know what that is, but I will do something. I'll become a dictator. I will probably do a coup. In the most positive way, and we will become Prime Minister for at least another 5 years. Yeah.
Oh my god. I'm like confused, mate. If I was Prime Minister for one day, I would. I would probably take away the. This is going to be so random. I don't know if it's appropriate. Take away the drug testing for the benefit.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah.
Okay. Who was your greatest role model growing up?
Oh, I'll start that one. My role model growing up is a male, and it's my grandfather. My grandfather, yes, so he raised me. He was the male figure, and I watched him respect all the women in our family. And he's never hit a woman, and he's a Cook Islander, and he barely speaks English, and he just lives the island life. And that's he brought his tradition, his ways from the island, and brought him here to Porirua, and that's my role model, my brother. Yeah.
We called her Nanny Mum. And she's always strong, always leading, always, you know, if you ever have a problem, you'll go to her. But also, you know, she'll back up your ears when you need it. So it's like a good balance. So yeah, she was always like that strong person that I wanted to be like. Yeah. I didn't really have one, to be honest. I pretty much, it was just me. Like, I had to teach myself. I had to mess up. Oh my god, I can't believe I'm not swearing. I had to mess up and learn from that, and that's what I did, because my relationship with my mum was, not the idea, but pretty much myself.
If you could go back 10 years and give yourself advice, what would you say?
Get your license, Pania. I would say that, you're going to go through some stuff in my class, right? You're going to lose your child's going to pass away, and from that you're going to go down. But man, you're going to come back up, and you're going to come back up way harder and faster than you ever did before, so just keep going.
Yeah, that's cool. I would say this, stay at school. Don't do drugs. Yeah.
Suicide is really bad at the moment, so what would you say to all the people that are giving up?
I'll start that one. One phrase, keep on keeping on. Keep on keeping on, my bro. Yeah.
Mine is not for the people that are going through it, it's the people that who are going to these people to ask for help. If someone's asking you for help, don't judge them. Don't say, well, it's not that bad, but that's the setup for failure, because it is that bad. We all work different, we all walk different paths, and just because their path doesn't seem as hard as yours doesn't mean they're not on a hard path. And then that's the thing we need to acknowledge, and just talk with them when they need us.
And mine is to find that just one person, and if that person doesn't want to listen, go to the next person, and go to the next person, and don't stop trying to find that one person that will listen to you.
Describe each other's greatest strength.
Oh, I'll start and it's for both of them. That both of them have walked through the fire and just keep going and just it's brought their greatness to the top. That's why I asked them to help me, to have on side of me like my pose, because my pose and my pose. Because I've seen both of them and then up, and they've only ever gone up, and you're only going to get stronger, and then that's what I see. It's like inner strength, but growth, the growth that a lot of people couldn't handle, and you've both done it easy as.
I agree with that.
Yeah, I love your design. Your dad's doing an amazing job raising you. You're going to be a great man, a great leader. Yeah. You see the man, wow. You're lucky, bro, you're lucky.
Yeah, I just want to congratulate your whole entire whānau. I grew up in the same neighbourhood, eh? And we went to the same schools and we've done the same activities, and I've seen you grow, and it's really, really humbling. It's really humbling to be at the table and to meet your boy. And to meet you, my bro. Hey, and that's what I want to say. And what I want to ask is, do you want me to sign Coey? He's a Coey the Rogue. Hey, not too much. Oh, wow. Yeah, this one too, you want to sign? Anyone, okay. Wow. This white one.
Look at me, like, autographing like I'm Beyonce. I'm like, get out of here.
Here we go, my work.
Oh man, I can find this is gonna be covered.
Yeah, this is so cool. This is so cool.
Thank you guys for coming and thank you guys for watching. Make sure you follow the Outmail official page. See you guys next time. Cheers.